Microsoft Word has mail merge, but it has two problems. One, you cannot put anyone in CC. And second, you cannot have a separate attachment. So let's solve both these problems using Power Automate. I have created a folder. It contains the list of contacts and the files which we will attach to the emails. The Excel file contains two tables. One table, the name is settings, and this contains two pieces of information which we will use in the Power Automate flow. The path of where the files are stored, this is relative path with respect to my OneDrive, and the subject which we will use to send the mail. The second table is called contacts, and this contains names, email IDs of people, CC, and the name of file attachments. The last column is important. Only if this column has the number 1 in it, then it will send the mail. Otherwise, it will not send the mail. Now let's build the flow in Power Automate. Go to Create option and choose Instant Cloud Flow. Instant means what? I'm going to trigger when the mail merge happens. It's not going to automatically work based on some other trigger. Otherwise, the mails will go multiple times. That's not what I want. Now, as soon as you create a flow, first step is the trigger, and then you add more steps. We are going to get two parameters from our Excel file. One is the path of the folder where the attachments are stored and the subject line. That is done by getting one row at a time from an Excel table. So add an action. Action happens in some application, in this case Excel. And there is a simple get a row option. We have to specify a lot of things, but OneDrive. Again, OneDrive. Choose the file by navigating the folder structure. Choose the table settings. In the settings table, the first item is items. That is the key column. And then when you specify one particular thing in the item column, it'll pick up the value from the second column, which is the value column. So it's sort of like VLOOKUP. So I want path. As soon as you create a step, rename it logically so things become easier. Now I want to use exactly similar step, except for the instead of path, I want to put subject. So I'm going to copy this to clipboard and then go to new step. And while you're on new step, you go to clipboard and say get folder path. Of course, we'll rename it to get subject. Now expand this, and the only thing we have to change here is the key value, which is subject. Now let's add the contacts table, new step. This time we don't want to get one row. We want to get the entire table. That's called list rows present in a table. Again, we have to repeat the location selection. So choose the contacts table. Now from here onwards, whatever we do, we want to apply to each row in the contacts table. So let's rename this get contacts data. Now this has multiple rows, and I have to apply whatever steps to each row of the data. So I'm going to add a new step. It's a control kind of step. And what are we doing? Apply to each. Now apply to each may sound more technical, so I'm going to call it process every contact. Now it's saying, OK, I'm going to process something, but where is that row coming from? That is coming from get contacts data, the previous step. Now here dynamic content shows get contacts data. For every row, it will give you a value. That value itself will contain all the data in that row. In the Excel file, we have an include column. If the include column contains one, we want to process the row. Otherwise, we don't. So it's a condition which we need to put now. Add an action. It is a control kind of thing, and we can see condition right here. Otherwise, you go to control and choose condition. Now in condition, we have to choose the value. Now values are coming from a row, and there is an include column here. So if include is equal to 1 in double quotes. So if include is equal to 1, do this part. If include is not equal to 1, then don't do anything. We are not going to add any action here. While we are at it, it's important to save the flow. So I'm going to call it mail merge with attachment and CC. MMA CC, click on save. Keep looking at this flow checker. If there are any mistakes, it will show you a red dot, and there you can go and figure out what the mistake is and correct it. Right now there are no mistakes. In the yes section, we will create the mail. But before we compose the mail, we need the file to be attached. File is in OneDrive, so we choose OneDrive. Now there are a lot of actions in OneDrive. We have the path of the file, so I want to choose get file content using path as the action. The path is composed of two things: the name of the attachment, which comes from the Excel sheet, and the path itself, which comes from the get folder path step. So use the path value first, followed by attachment name. Now is the time to create the mail. Email is created using Outlook 365. In Outlook 365, we have send an email V2. V2 is the latest version. This is the new interface, so you have to open this, click on this flash, and then email 2. Subject, we have already got in a separate step where get subject, the value portion. The body text, right now I'm just putting sample body text. You can create a more extensive body text, invitation text, whatever you want to put as a part of the mail merge. I did not do that in Excel because this gives you more formatting capabilities. But wait, we want to put a CC as well. So say show advanced options. Now there is option for putting CC. And here we have email CC coming from the Excel sheet itself. The final thing we want to do is attachments. Now attachment has two components: the file content itself and the name of the file. The name of the file we already have in Excel. So open this. Now you will see get contacts data, which is the Excel portion, but you see only one value. Click on see more, and then you will see all the fields or columns. That's the name of the attachment, and the content we are going to get from the get file content using path. That gives you the file content. And that is how you compose an email in Power Automate. Once all this is done, everything looks OK. Flow checker is clean. Click on it anyway. No errors, no warnings. Close it, save it. And now is the time to test it. In our data, if everything goes well, boss should get a mail with sample 2.pdf. And sales should get a mail with sample 3.pdf. To test the flow, click on the test button. This is a manual flow, so you'll have to invoke it. Click on test. It'll check all your connections, and then if everything is OK, it'll tell you to run the flow. Now to monitor it, you have to go to flow runs page. When you click done, that page comes automatically. It'll show you every step, and the green tick mark indicates that it is finished or not, how long it took. And all are green, so everything should be OK. And there we have it. Boss received a mail invitation. That subject came from Excel, sample 2.pdf. And sales also received the same invitation, sample 3.pdf. So everything is working as expected. Now in real life, we'll put more data in the Excel sheet. If it is different file per person, that is also supported. If it's the same file, just keep one file in the folder and copy paste the file name across. And of course, you can decide which person actually gets the message or not by using the include column. So this is a fairly flexible way of managing mail merge with attachments and CCs. When you're ready, go to Power Automate, My Flows, find MMACC, and click the run button. One word of caution and warning. And even if you are using Microsoft, when you send a mail which has too many people too fast, it can be flagged as spam. And there are certain rules which decides what is spam. So discuss it with your IT team before you suddenly decide to send a mail blast. It may not only land you into trouble, your servers also may get blacklisted. I hope now you understand how Power Automate can help us orchestrate across different apps and get our job done. I recently published an interesting video on how to visually identify mails where you are on BCC. Have a look at that. I'm sure you'll like it, and you will learn about Outlook rules more effectively. So that's it for now. Thank you.